Hi, this is Carrie Ann with Dress Haute TV, and this is part of our Dress Haute TV series. I'm bringing to you today my Dress Haute Teen Talk, where we're talking about issues that our teenagers deal with on a daily basis and how we can help you overcome and be the best person that you can be. And we're going to have this series a part of the Dress Haute TV once a month, and I have four girls from throughout different schools in the area, and we're going to talk about some real deep issues as far as what teens deal with on a daily basis. And remember, embrace yourself, love yourself, and dress hot style. So Bethany, we're going to tell us a little bit about yourself and what brought you to Dress Haute TV.
Well, I'm Bethany. I mainly just kind of chill out with my life, but I decided a couple years ago to get a homecoming dress from Carrie Ann, and well, one thing led to another. I did a fashion show, another one, a few photo shoots here and there, and now we're here.
Okay. What school are you from?
Cannon Mac.
Okay, awesome. Tell me a little bit. Are you junior, senior?
Junior.
Is there any activities that you do inside school?
Inside of school, I'm a part of costume crew. That's about it. Oh, I'm part of the Latin society, but.
Okay. Yeah. So we're going to introduce Zoe, who is another one of our Teen Talk guests. And Zoe, tell us a little bit about yourself.
So I'm Zoe and I'm 17. I go to Manessa in high school. I started Dress Haute a couple years ago. I did a couple shows for Carrie and then some photo shoots, and it led me here. And I'm really into makeup and fashion, and that's it. I'm part of the French club in my school.
Okay, perfect.
I'm Mackenzie. I'm 18 years old, and I go to Peters Township. The first time I met Carrie Ann, I fell in love with her. She is just so fun to be around. She just makes everyone's day. I got a homecoming dress from her, and it was gorgeous. I loved it. We turned it was actually a prom dress, and then we cut it off to make it a homecoming dress, and I loved it. I do a couple clubs at school. I am in FBLA, that's Future Business Leaders of America, and I'm in Interact and Best Buddies and a lot of other clubs, and I do the musical also.
I'm Emma. I go to Baldwin High School. I'm 17 years old, so I'm in 11th grade. I met Carrie Ann when I was also shopping for a homecoming dress, and it was gorgeous. I wasn't even expecting to buy one that day, and just the atmosphere of your store was amazing, and it made me want to come back. And eventually, I started, you must have called me, and you were like, I have this fashion show that I want you to do. So one thing led to another. I did a photo shoot with you, and now I'm here. At school, I'm on the Baldwin tennis team. I do Minithon, which raises money for childhood cancer. I'm part of teams and captains club, things like that.
Okay, cool. Basically, we brought everybody here because you guys are going to be part of the Dress Haute Teen Talk, which we're going to talk about topics that you guys deal with every day at school, and you know, just try to how we can help other people in school to deal with the same types, because I know you guys are all from different backgrounds, different schools, and I guarantee you somebody's dealing with the same thing. So we're going to kind of like go through some questions and just kind of be free and pass the mic around as to, you know, who would want to answer. Our first question we're going to ask is, at what age does body image and self-esteem become an issue?
For me, at least, was when I was probably around 13 years old, the middle school years. I had never really thought about my body before, you know. Then I started to realize, wow, like, I'm a lot taller than the average girl here, and I got really self-conscious about it. I think people need to remember that there's always something about them that they're not always going to like, but you can embrace that and make it fit who you are.
Okay. I would have to say, like, sophomore year, because, like, I was, like, used to high school, and I, like, got used to, like, seeing people's fashion, because I used to just wear, like, super, like, I dressed like mom, like, I was, like, I didn't know what to wear, and then I kind of, like, was, like, okay, there's other people wearing this outfit, I feel like I have to wear this to fit in with everyone, but then now I'm, like, getting older, I'm, like, I can do what I, if I want to wear this, I can wear this. I'm happy with my body.
Okay.
I'd say it was probably when I was about 13. I was bigger than everybody and taller than everybody. And I just feel like I started evolving, and then I started modeling, and it just made me feel a lot better about myself. And everybody thought it was awesome that I did it, and everybody loved everything I did. So I think that really helped me.
For me, I think it was around, like, honestly, like, fourth or fifth grade. Like, I was, like, young whenever I started feeling self-conscious, because, like, you know, I was a lot shorter than everyone else. So, I don't know. I was a lot more outgoing than everyone else, so I kind of got the back end of the fork or whatever. but I don't know. I'm not self-conscious anymore. I think that really stopped whenever I started modeling, which I think is also, like, a big misconception, because everyone's always like, oh, when you start modeling, you just become more self-conscious, and you watch everything you eat, and you do all this stuff because you compare yourself to others. But I found that it's honestly the opposite. Like, most of the people that I've met have done nothing but, like, lift each other up and, like, make one another feel good about themselves, instead of, like, putting each other down, like the media and Hollywood makes it seem.
No, I agree, because even when I was growing up, I've always struggled with my body shape, my size, and, like, how I felt confident. And that's where I feel that Dress Haute has come to play, because we embrace everybody's curves, regardless what, you know, size, what height, you know, what sex, origin, or whatever. And it's just, we want everybody to feel beautiful, because there's always beauty with inside everybody. It's just a matter of somebody giving that to you, where your beauty is, and, like, bringing it out of you so that you feel confident in yourself in order to be able to, you know, be beautiful and feel beautiful, because that's the biggest thing. It's like feeling good in your skin. You can be a size 30 and you still, you can be the most beautiful thing, because it's how you all carry yourself, right? Good. So let's go to our second question. What role does social media have on a good or bad image?
I think it really, for me personally, it really depends on the platform. So, like, if you're using something like Instagram, you're probably going to compare yourself to other people. But if you're using, like YouTube or, like, TikTok, I feel like it really, like, changes a little bit, because people are more, less about your body and more about the content that you make on those platforms. But then, like, the picture medias, that's where it's, like, okay, this is what everyone thinks my body should look like, so that's what I should look like. But I don't know, I think it really depends.
So I think it can have a good or bad thing. Depends on who the person is that is explaining it and showing it, because you can go on YouTube and there can be someone that is beautiful and loves themselves and shows you, like, that to love yourself. And I think also you can go on Instagram and someone's advertising Photoshop or flat tummy tea or whatever it is, and then it can be bad. But I think it just is good or bad, and just depends on what it is.
Social media can be good and can be bad, and, like, there's apps that can show you that they're, like, you can be skinny, but, like, you have to think to yourself, do you really want to show people that you use an app? You don't. You want to show people your real self and your real body, because you should be happy with your body and everything. That's why Dress Haute shows you that you can be any size, any curve, or anything.
For me, I used to really have, like, a bad connection with social media. I always wanted to look like the models that I followed or all the girls in school that I would see have their clothes, their haircut, whatever it was. And I think people should embrace the good side of it. Like, make your own mark on social media. Be who you want to be. Don't base yourself off of everyone else who you see on there, because you are your own personal self that you can shape into whatever you want to be or whoever you want to be.
Okay. So let's go on to the next question. What are some things that can help with negative body issues that, for anybody who is watching, we'd be able to help them?
Honestly, I took a long, hard look in the mirror and said, you know what, you are gorgeous. Sometimes I sing at myself in the mirror. I don't know what you guys do. It helps me. I talk to my mom a lot about it. Being a model with you made me realize that, you know, my height doesn't matter. If I have acne, it doesn't really matter. You know what, I can do this. I'm gorgeous, and I just need to know that.
Just tell yourself you're beautiful. Like, you don't need some guy to tell you, or some girl to tell you, oh, wow, you're beautiful. You just need to tell yourself that. You're yourself. You're the person who can make your own decisions. If you're happy with your body, stay with your body. Don't change it for anyone or anything. Just be yourself and love yourself. And with Dress Hot, she lets you embrace your body and she doesn't judge you or anything. She just lets you be you.
I think what they said, but also I think just like talking to people about it and talking about how you feel and encouraging people to, because if you're like you're on social media and your friend posts something, you can post like, you look so beautiful or something just to empower other people, and then also empower yourself by posting those things and not caring what anybody else thinks about you. And I think that that is the best way.
Okay.
I think it varies based on the person, in my opinion. Like, I feel like some people just need, like, some self-care, you know, some, like, reassurance in themselves. But I think others might need, like, more of a bigger, like, help, like, talking to someone who really can help you. And I think it really just depends. Like, if you're comparing yourself to someone every day and it gets to an unhealthy point, I think that's when you really need to, like, talk to someone and not hold it back, because I feel like for a while it's not as bad anymore, but there was this huge taboo about like body issues and like, oh, this is how you have to be, and it's not really like that anymore. I feel like it's more you can be whoever you want and it doesn't matter.
Well, back when I was younger, which was like yesterday, you know, it was challenging because you had all the, you know, I was a cheerleader, but I was always the bigger cheerleader. I was always the one that threw people up in the air and had to catch them. And it just that being your body build is a little bit bigger than the average, you just don't feel as if, you know, you're beautiful. And back then, we didn't have social media. You know, we didn't have TikTok. I just learned about TikTok. I have but it was just that it was a struggle. And it took me years to really be able to embrace who I was as a person and realize that I have a lot of positive characteristics and that I can light up a room and, you know, just really love who I am in order to, you know, be the Carrie Ann that I can be, right? Yeah. So let's ask about how has modeling affected body image and self-esteem?
Okay, well, for me personally, it's really helped, like, personally with how I view myself, because I felt like before I was constantly, like, outgoing and to a point where it was annoying, honestly. And, like, but I wasn't, like, a happy person, per se. But now since I've started modeling, I've become a happier person myself. And I trust myself more, and I understand myself more, because modeling you have to lock into a different part of yourself for everything that you do. And I feel like each time that you have to do that, you find another part of you that helps you grow as a person. I don't know.
I think modeling's helped me a lot. It's just made me feel that no matter what size I am, no matter how tall I am, I still can be beautiful and I can still walk a runway and look just like a model. And to me, it just really helps with my confidence. And getting my hair and makeup done and putting on a beautiful dress just makes me feel a lot better. And yeah.
From like years through my high school life, I've been like very like scared about my body. I'm scared to show it off. But then when I started modeling for Carrie Ann, I told myself like, no one's gonna judge me because no one else is gonna get up on a stage and show off how beautiful her dress is off. And I love my body because the dresses show my features, because they're just making me feel better about myself. And today in 2020, you see plus size models and Victoria's Secret and other stuff, and just making like everyone feel better because you don't have to be this skinny mini girl anymore. You can be this gorgeous bigger girl, or you can be a skin mini, but you still feel good about yourself.
Okay.
I would have never in a million years thought I could have been a model. And then I met Carrie Ann, and it has empowered me so much. I honestly thought I would have never been able to do it for her. And then I was like, you know what? You got this, you know? But yeah, I was very, very shy until I did this. And I can't kind of help me come out of my shell a little bit more. And I can finally like walk around and be like, yeah, I model. Exactly. Yeah. I have this new like a little bit flair to me, and I'm a little bit more outgoing than I was before. So yeah.
Cool. Okay, so what are some issues that lead to depression in teens?
I think concealing your emotions about things that upset you. I don't think people should be as bottled up about things that they're feeling, even if you're feeling slightly upset about, I don't know, like a test you took and you think, oh my goodness, this is like the second test I failed. Go talk to someone, maybe that'll lead to like a happier ending for you. I don't know. Yeah.
What you were saying, yeah, I feel like people get just so stressed about certain stuff, and then the stress takes over them, and it takes over their eating and how they like hang out with their friends, and it just takes over so much. And then you're like, what happened to our friendship? What happened to you? Like, it's just so much. Everyone thinks they have to be like perfect, like a number 10. You don't have to be a number 10. If you think you're a number 10, you're a number 10. If you keep telling yourself that you're the best, like, you'll believe it and you know that you're the best. Don't let other people tell you like you're bad. You're gorgeous and everything.
I think what they said, I just think once you express yourself and talk to people, it just makes you feel better. And I think the big part of it is bottling it up, and that's what makes you depressed and can lead to other things. But I think once you get out of that shell and just express yourself more, whether it's making a video or posting something on social media that makes you feel good, I think that just really helps just opening up.
I feel like when you're a teenager, you're really trying to come to terms with who you are as a person. You know, there's so many questions you have to answer about yourself. Granted, you don't ever have to actually answer them, but there's stuff that you need to figure out as yourself, and sometimes that leads you on a path that isn't the best, even if you have the best intentions for yourself. Sometimes, like, I feel like you'll think one thing, and then you'll think about another thing, and then you'll think about another thing, and soon after you're thinking about that for days, and then you're in this cycle, and you become like depressed, or something happens, and then it's just a constant cycle of who am I, what am I doing with my life, where am I supposed to go after this? And I think that really, really stresses us out, and it really makes us think, and I think that sometimes thinking is not the best thing for us to be doing.
I agree. So, okay, so we're gonna let's follow up with our last question here. This is a very important topic that a lot of teenage girls deal with as well. How common are eating disorders in teenage girls, and what do you think leads to this behavior?
Well, they are very common. I don't think people realize that. I think a lot of times also adults only see like two or three eating disorders, but there are so many that everyone can have. Like, anyone can have them and you wouldn't know. I think a lot of times too, people only think that like girls can have them, but genuinely anybody can have one. And I think it's really important to be there for them and to make sure that they're getting the help that they need and to make sure that they're keeping themselves healthy.
So I think they're very common, and I think that there is a misconception about them, like she said, about how people think it's only girls that have it. I think social media has to do with it, with people like acting like they eat perfectly, but I think that is probably not all the truth. And I think that once you need help, once you get it, it just will, you know, obviously help you And yeah.
About eating disorders and stuff, I have a friend right now, and she has lost so much weight, and she has never come opened up to me, and I'm very scared about it. I want to make sure she's okay. And with that, girls, they're like, oh, I'll eat tomorrow, or I'll eat something tonight, but they don't, and they just make their body think that they're not hungry, and that's horrible because you're hurting your body and you're hurting yourself. And how people think about you, no one's judging you. You just think they're judging you about eating disorders and everything. I feel like in everyone's high school, in my opinion, there's someone who had an eating disorder or has one or is becoming, or I don't know the correct term, but has one and won't tell someone. It's too scared to tell them that this is happening to my body, because you're scared because you don't want to lose anyone. But when it's happening, it just controls your whole life then, because then you can't stop. But I feel like if you reach out for help and everything, there's a way at the end of the road, you'll find help.
This is actually a question pretty near and dear to my heart. My sister had an eating disorder, and it was when she was in her teenage years, and she kept all of everything bottled up inside her. No one knew that she was thinking all these horrible things about herself, and that she needed to lose weight and she needed to look like the skinniest girl in school or whoever. And this was even before social media time. So now social media has an even more prevalent impact on how we see ourselves and, oh, how big should I be? What size jeans should I wear? You know, just stressing yourself out about what you should look like, the perfect image of yourself, really leads to you trying to change yourself into something that you're not.
So if you had one advice based off all the topics that we talked about today for a girl who could be dealing with their self-esteem, you know, dealing with social media, eating disorder, what would you give them?
You really need to embrace every aspect of yourself, whether or not you're ready to accept it. Everything about you can be beautiful if you choose to see it that way.
Communication is key. You need to talk to the people and just be yourself. Love yourself so much. You don't need other people to tell you that. Just love yourself and everything.
So I think you just need to love yourself and just look at yourself in the mirror and say you're beautiful because you are. Don't let anybody tell you you're not, and just live life to the fullest. And yeah.
Just, you don't have to compare yourself to other people. Just, I know it's so hard to, but just take a step back if you need one. Do what you need to do to get better. Do what you need to do to make yourself happy, because really that's what you need. You don't need the pressure of wanting to look like this one person because everyone says that you should. Just be who you need to be and not who everyone else wants you to be.
Sorry. You said something and you also, and I was just thought, so, because it's 2020 and you look at the new artist people, Lizzo. Mm-hmm. She tells everyone she loves her body. She shows off her body. And that's what we need now in 2020. We need to show off our bodies and just embrace it like Lizzo does and everything. So I just wanted to say that.
Shout out to Lizzo.
Yeah, shout out to Lizzo.
We're not going to show as much as Lizzo.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We're going to keep it clean.
Yeah, keep it clean, but just look at Lizzo and she embraces her body and everything, and no one's judging her. She just loves her body.
So. No, I think it's true. If you take a look at even on, there's a lot more curvier women that are on TV that make it to the award shows, that make it that are singers now than in the past. And I think that's, you know, a positive thing, because they are creating that body positive, which that's very important for anybody, regardless, even if you're a size 2 or 0, you still have dealings that you don't feel comfortable in your own skin. So anything that we could do as, you know, a person to help somebody out, to make them feel body positive, is a win-win, because that makes, you know, just spread the love And, you know, I think that with Dress Haute, I mean, as you guys stated, it is about embracing, because it's a challenge sometimes to go out there and find a dress or find something that's going to make you feel good. Because let's face it, if we all feel good on the outside of the clothes that we wear and we have our makeup done and stuff, we feel like, you know, we're awesome. That's what my husband says whenever I'm like Carrie Ann, but when I do those fashion shows, my lashes go on. It is Carrie Ann, you know, so it's totally different. Yeah. But I mean, it's true, and everybody wants to feel beautiful, you know, and that's the goal. I mean, because you want to enjoy life. I appreciate you guys coming out and, you know, introducing and taking the time. And we're going to continue, you know, talking like each month as far as our Dress Haute Teen Talk series. We're going to have more questions as far as dating, proms coming up, you know, how you ask that guy, right? You know, some will be moving on to college. You know, how do you decide what school you go to? And, you know, any type of talk that we can help others out there is what we're going to be talking about. And this is our four girls that we have chosen to be a part of our teen talk for Dress Haute and our Dress Haute TV series. So I appreciate it. And thank you for coming today.